Marilyn Rocky is on the phone calling in after we just told this story. Marilyn, hi.
Hi.
Hi. Now, do you prefer we call you Marilyn or Landlordess, or can we call you Rocky, or what would you like?
All three will work. I know who I am.
Okay. All right. So did I get any of this wrong from the published reports?
No, actually, you were right on. I mean, there are a lot of other, you know, details in between, but you got the essence, and that the story was pretty well told.
How nuts does this drive you, first of all, once you found out all those years later when you ran into Clarence Clemons that you had this gold mine of memorabilia, but you never knew it? I mean, does it still eat at you, or have you long since gotten over it?
Well, it was a bit of a shock because I never had any interest in the piano, and every subsequent tenant left it there. And when I ran into Clemons at the dentist that day, mm-hmm. and he told me, I was shocked. And somebody, I think you mentioned, or somebody mentioned that, you know, you can't believe that these guys didn't tell me.
Yes.
But, you know.
Yeah, why do you think that was?
Because they were kids. I mean, they probably celebrated the end, the last song being written, signed the thing, and life went on, and suddenly the album gets produced. They're on the cover of Time. Bruce is on the cover of Time and Newsweek. I don't think I was, you know, the first thing on their mind and their signatures on the piano. I don't think it was something they were thinking about at the time.
Did you ever find out? Do you even remember when he moved out of your old bungalow compared to the time that the album took off and blew up and he made the double magazine covers and all that?
He had to move out by September 1975 because he had been on the cover of Newsweek and Time in August, and the house was becoming sort of like Plymouth Rock. Everybody was chipping on at the stucco.
Oh,
and
no kidding.
Love notes. And
oh, my God.
They,
wow.
Everybody, you know, Bruce had lived there, and nobody paid him any attention.
Yeah.
For the year and a half that he was there.
Yeah.
And now he was somebody that they wanted to get to see and to know. And so he very discreetly left, and I got a note from his managing group, Laurel Canyon, saying, you know, they were very sorry, but Bruce had to leave, and you know, I hope it wasn't not a big deal because he didn't play out the second year lease.
Wow. I'm so glad you're telling us that part, because that part has not made any of the published articles that I read, but that's so cool. So he didn't really plan it this way. It was almost forced on him to move out.
Yeah, he suddenly, after all that time, he was noticed, and
yeah.
That's the other interesting thing about the house, because he left, as I said, in the fall of 75, and I re-rented it a number of times, and nobody after 20 years really knew anything about the house. I mean, there was sort of like, well,